Hey, today we're gonna try another kitchen experiment. We're gonna head out to the backyard, pick as many violets as we can find, the nice deep common blue ones, and then we're gonna try to make a violet syrup. So you can use that in lemonade or other types of drinks, and it's fairly simple, so we're gonna give it a shot today. Okay, we've popped out to the backyard and we're gonna try to fill up our bowl here with violets. So I've already started collecting some, but I want to kind of show you. I'm going to just point the camera down and kind of give you a glimpse of what I'm really looking at here. Okay, we've got a number of little violet plants here. Now, you'll see if you can tell, there's some clover and some, looks like some wood sorrel and some stuff mixed in with this grass too, but we're looking at plants with a leaf that looks like this. It's kind of waxy, it's almost heart-shaped. That's our blue violet, but really, right now, we're just looking for the flowers. So we're gonna pick these and we're gonna take the stems off. Now you can do this inside or outside. So I've just been tossing them in this bowl, but if you wanna go ahead and sort of strip them while you're in the field, you can. So if you just get as close as you can to the bottom of the flower head and just kind of pinch the stem off, that works well too. So we're just gonna try to fill up this bowl. We're gonna need a ton of violets, so we're probably gonna travel all over this magical backyard. So get as many as you can, and then we'll be taking them inside and doing our next steps. Okay, so I've got all my stems and my flower heads removed. So again, you know, you really wanna make sure you have all of the stem off. So just be aware of that. I can put my flower heads aside over here, or my stems aside over here, we don't need those. But I do want about 2 cups of flour. So I'm just gonna measure them. Oops, one left here. Looks like I'm a little shy of 2 cups, so I'm gonna go ahead and head outside and try to get some more. Now you wanna have a lot of violets, so that's why I'm just going with like a 2 full cups to give me like a pretty good baseline to start with. Okay, we're coming to our next steps now. Now this process actually isn't that short. I probably should have warned you. It does take an overnight or 24 hours to finish this, but we can finish most of the steps today. So I did get rid of all the rest of my stems. I'm gonna set them aside. I got a lot more violets, so I just wanna make sure I had the most. And the more green that you can pull off of here, the better. So make sure you get all the stem off and leaves and anything like that. Now you need 2 cups of water because I have roughly 2 cups, actually probably more than 2 cups of violets, because I wanna make sure I have a really good syrup that comes out as a result. And then you either need a mason jar or a saucepan. Now, you're gonna boil some water and then you gotta leave it overnight. So you have to have a container that you can put hot boiled water into. I'm gonna go ahead and just leave mine in the saucepan overnight, so I'm not gonna use this jar, but lots of people go with the jar method. So it's really what you have on hand. And if you don't have a lid for a saucepan and you don't have a jar, you could use tin foil or something like that. So it's not like you have to have these perfect items. You can make do with what you can find in your kitchen. So I'm just gonna pull my lid off, dump in 2 cups of water, and then I need to bring that to a boil. So I'm gonna crank this dude up and I'm going to give it a few minutes to come to a boil before I add my violets. Okay, my water is just about to a boil. Looks like it's just about there, so I need to make sure I have a spoon handy and I have a hot pad here, because what I'm gonna do, oh, there it's boiling. I'm gonna turn it off and then I'm gonna set my boiling water for 5 minutes just to rest. And once it cools down just a tiny bit, then we'll be adding the violets. Okay, the water has just come off the boil. It's been about 5 minutes just to sort of take the edge off, and I'm about to put my violets in, but before I do, I'm just gonna stick my face in this bowl because, oh my gosh, if you've never duck your face in a bowl of freshly picked violets, you're missing out. So go ahead and do that. I'll give you a second. Super, super awesome. And then you're just going to get these in here. Oh, one little straggler. And then I'm gonna kind of push them down in here. Like so, make sure they're all covered with water. And then I am going to put the lid on this. And we're done for the day. So tomorrow, when this video picks back up, we'll be going through the processing steps. So right now you gotta let it sit overnight. 24 hours is best. So we'll be back here shortly. All right, we are back from 24 hours of letting this dude hang out here, and the water gets really nicely infused with the violets. So our next step is we need to strain the violets out of the water. And then there's a cooking element that's gonna come up next. So you wanna have on hand, we really need a double boiler. I don't have a double boiler, so I'm going to make one by taking this stock pot here. Gonna ditch the lid because I don't need it. And then I'm just gonna take another bowl that I know can get hot and cook and set it down in there. So I've kind of made a double boiler that way. Now, if you have like any kind of saucepan and you have like a metal bowl or a Pyrex or something that you can stick in there, or another saucepan, that's fine. The point is you don't want the water to touch the other pan that you're putting in there. So we're really heating by steam so it doesn't get too hot. So I am gonna strain into this bowl since it's gonna be the top of my boiler. Okay, as I'm straining the liquid out, I'm also gonna try to, and I'm just using like this old strainer that I use for just whatever other stuff, but you wanna make sure it's kind of a fine mesh on there so you don't have a lot of stuff sticking through there. You could use some cheesecloth, you could use whatever you have on hand. This just happened to be the handiest to me, but I am gonna press down and try to get all the liquid out that I can. And then you see this sad little lump of flowers that we have left. I'll stick this in the old compost here in a bit. That looks pretty good. So you can see we've got this really cool purpley liquid now. Our next step is we need to measure how much we have, because for each cup of liquid we have to add 2 cups of sugar, which is like an obscene amount of sugar, but that's what you need to make syrup. Okay, I've got my liquid all strained out. My next step is I need to start my water sort of heating up in the bottom half of my double boiler. So I'm gonna go ahead and add water to it. There we go. And turn it on to kind of, I want it to boil, and then I'm gonna back it off the boil and kind of leave it simmering. So I'm gonna heat it up, you know, kind of fast, and then I need to turn it down to a simmer. But in the meantime, I can use this big old thing to see how much liquid we actually have here. Let's see. Looks like we've got exactly 2 cups, so very cool. I can pour that back into my container that's going to be the top of the double boiler. Ooh. Okay, so the next part, my water is doing pretty good. It's at a nice simmer right now. So I'm going to stick my bowl right down in there. Make sure you don't burn yourself like I just almost did. And then my massive supply of sugar. I'm gonna stir this in slowly so it dissolves. So I don't wanna just dump it all in at once. You can kind of do that. My boil bowl is like pretty small, so I wanna be a little careful about it. So I'm gonna start adding it bit by bit and stirring it. Okay, just keep adding the sugar and stirring it in. The goal is to get it all to dissolve. Now it's gonna take a little bit of time and patience, but should be worth it. I'm just gonna keep doing that. Okay, well, I've basically been stirring for, I don't know, 10 minutes or something, and I think I've got my sugar just about all dissolved. And I read somewhere that I can change the color of this syrup if I add just a couple drops of lemon juice. So this is an experiment, and you know what? I'm gonna try it. So got some lemon juice, and I'm just gonna put a few drops on the spoon and then stir it in that way. Not really seeing much of a difference. Pop a few more in there. Ooh, it is a little darker. That is super cool. So you can leave it without the lemon juice and it's still like a lavender color. I just wanted to try this because why not? I might be going overboard here. Man, that is awesome. Okay, I think it's time to let this cool. And then I'm gonna dig up a container to put this in. It should last for about 6 months in your fridge. So let's let this chill out a bit. And we'll go find a container. Well, as you can see, we have finished our process. Barnaby's checking it out. Thanks, buddy. Thanks for helping. I ended up getting a pretty good amount of syrup to come out. Found some cool containers to put them in. And then I did go ahead and mix up some lemonade. So I'm just gonna add a few spoonfuls to my lemonade and see how that tastes. Actually smells like really sort of earthy. It has a really cool scent to it. So, ooh. Oh my gosh, guys, it's totally awesome. We've done good today. Our experiment was good. So let me know how you end up using your violet syrup if you make some. I'm just gonna flash our instructions up here real quick. And good luck. I hope you try this and I hope it turns out well.